Hey, it's me, Crystal Casino. Welcome to my gaming video. It's four, as you can see, it's 4:46 a.m. I really should not be awake, but I am because I just finished watching ReZero with my friend, and so I'm awake later than I would usually be. But instead of going to sleep, I figured I already screwed up my sleep schedule, so I'm just gonna play some video games. That's just random stuff on itch that you guys probably never heard of, and I can expose you to some cool video games. I'm gonna turn myself up. I tried to record something for a game that someone in a server I am in made called what is it, brainstormed brain. Well, it's, I don't have it open. Yeah, I don't know, but it's I think it's brainstormed or brainstorming, but it was really cool. But the OBS was really laggy, and so I didn't even save the whole video. And it was like basically a slideshow. So that was a failure. So I'm really upset about that. But we're gonna try this game instead because it's in the browser. This one seems cool. It's called Under a Star Called Sun. It's about a grieving, apparently, and holding on to fading memories and carrying the world on your shoulders. This is interesting. I mean, I've experienced grief once before, and it was not very fun. So I'm interested to see what this is. This is about. I feel like it's gonna be pretty artsy. I'm kind of excited. Should I make it full screen? Yeah, I'll do that. Is there. Did I press something? Oh, okay. It's X. I wake up. The sun gently caresses my face. And for a second, I believe I'm back on Earth. Oh, okay. So it's interactive. Let's go down here. Did I get this? I guess it's anything in color. I mixed myself some coffee, and you laugh if I said, it never tastes as good as the ones you get from the cafes back home. I would turn back and go home, but the trajectory of the ship is unchanging. Okay, I understand what to do now. I look at the colored stuff. I check on the plants in the greenhouse. I check for bugs. I check the moisture of the soil. I check the dust on the leaves. And when no one's around, I hum to them. In a normal message, I'd be saying shit like, "How's it going? What's new? So when are you finally gonna move to Melbourne? I'm so excited to see you again." Oh, Atlas holds up the firmament and endures one day at a time. I guess I'll probably go this way. No, well, there's signs pointing that way, but I remember when I first heard the news. I woke up earlier than usual, and I get a message from our friend. My phone freezes, and one could attribute this to planned obsolescence. But maybe. You know, there's a room on this ship. I won't tell you how it works. And oh shit, I missed it. It's late mor- Oh, I think it's the last time I saw. It's late morning on a perfectly ordinary August day. We're meeting up for brunch at a cafe close to mine. A lineup of friends I only see occasionally. I think you ordered a fancy sandwich, or maybe just a salad. Then we sat in the park and talked for a while. You had to get going, meeting another friend. Oh, okay. You stepped on the 19 tram to North Coburg and smiled, framed between the pneumatic doors, beautiful under the fluorescent light. You said, "See you next time." Was it sunny or cloudy that day? What did you order? What did we talk about? What did your voice sound like? What was the expression on your face when we said goodbye? The memory gets corrupted with each new iteration of it, like a wave washing over writings on sand, over and over. Like a cassette tape played over and over. Like a JPEG saved over and over. You know what I'm talking about. You'd laugh about this comparison too. The deep-fried meme of memory. I think it's funny too. But one day the memory will be so distorted that I won't get to see you anymore. I wish I had made more of an effort to remember. I wish I had taken more photos. When a perfectly ordinary day turns into a perfectly extraordinary day, who do you blame for misfiling a memory in the file cabinets of your brain? The trajectory of the ship is unchanging, and if nothing else, I must cherish the approximate. Oh, Atlas holds up our poisoned world and endures once more. And I'm writing this, and I know I'm a visual person, and it's not like he'll write back from the far edges of outer space. But one day I'll get there, and I'll hug you, and I'll say I miss you, and I'll say I love you. Until then, I check on the plants in the greenhouse, I check for bugs, I check the moisture of the soil, I check the dust on the leaves, and when no one's around, I hum to them. Oh, okay. That was not a good... Well, that was really good. That was a bit of an awkward start to this video. Oh my goodness. Well, good job. Yeah, well, that was clearly very personal. But, you know, at the same time... I'm gonna follow this person. Have they made anything else? God, a lot of these are sad. this one's a party game. This one looks nice. Hey, let's play this one. Novena. No, same font. Oh, this music is fancy. Okay. Oh, it's the same. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Same gameplay scheme. Everyone knows the ocean listens to you and grant wishes. I kind of skipped through that on accident. Oh my goodness, this music is loud. I hope y'all can hear me. One must ask the ocean for 9 days. But these days the people are angry. The ocean hasn't responded. The ocean no longer grants wishes. Oh, whoops. No, stop. Okay. Will you try? For you're young, and so is the night. Well, I have to, right? Oh, this is so nice. The ebb tide takes you in its jaw. You finally find the ocean. The ocean weeps. I will not listen again. I will not grant wishes again. Damn, ocean. You decide to try again tomorrow. The ocean weeps. I always listen. I always help. But who helps the ocean? Who listens to the ocean? I will not grant wishes again. You decide to try again tomorrow. The ocean weeps. People always say, I am strong. I am resilient. Is it why no one asks me if I'm okay? I will not grant wishes again. Decide to try again tomorrow. Okay, I figured it was Roman numerals. The ocean weeps. You ask, are you okay? I'm listening. The ocean doesn't respond. Whoa. Okay. The ocean weeps. Why do you care? You only want your wish. Everyone only wants their wish. Is this why I exist? I will not grant wishes again. Decide to try again tomorrow. Okay. The ocean weeps, you say, I'm not here for a wish. I'm here to feel the sand, the wind, the water. On the first night, I came here to die. The ocean weeps. You promise to visit tomorrow. The ocean weeps. You ask why. I weep, for we are the same, and I don't know how to help us. These are so artsy. Not in a bad way. I like it, but it's artsy. It doesn't really fit my tone of voice. The ocean tells you that it likes you being around, that its world is better with you around, that it wants to listen to you. I promise to visit tomorrow. Oh my god, this is really pretty. Holy crap. The ocean weeps. Thanks for being around. You listened and it helped. And I cried and it helped. And you stayed and it helped. And now I will help. Make a wish. I will help. You wish to visit tomorrow. Huh. That was good. These are both good. I'm gonna play, oh, I can comment. I'm gonna comment on the other one. But okay, I'm gonna pause it, and then when I come back, we're playing a different game. Let's go!